Now, I've found a hidden treasure right here in Crow's Nest in Sydney, and that's Ravi's Cumin, which is known among its locals for its authentic Indian cuisine. So let's go inside and take a look around. Ravi's Cumin prides itself on blending modern methods and traditional techniques to bring to you the most authentic Indian cuisine. Ravi's Cumin caters for all tastes and age groups, and their extensive menu includes vegetarian options, seafood options, and children's banquets. And I couldn't think of anybody better than the head chef Ravi Gandhi to tell you all about the menu.
Here at Ravi's Cumin, we try and concentrate on typical North Indian cuisine, the way it's cooked at home. Well, the basic ingredients we use are the cumin seeds, like we have them here, the coriander seeds, the coriander powder with it, red chilies, we have the haldi powder, which is turmeric, we have the ajwain seeds, which are very close to your caraway seeds, we have the curry leaves and the whole of the garam masalas. We use them either as ground powder or we use them as whole when we are cooking a curry. That's the fenugreek, the methi as we call them, and the kasuri methi, which is the powdered dry variety of the same thing. What we have done today is prepared a mixed entree platter here, where we have the chandni kebab, which is a chicken infused with mozzarella cheese. We have the lamb cutlets, which are marinated in basically ginger, garlic, and just finished with a few spices like cumin. We have the calamari here, and the prawn. The prawn that we do is typically more flavor of garlic. It's what we call the lasuni jinga. Apart from the entrees, what we've done here is the traditional dal makhani, which is a dal every Indian woman knows to cook in the north. We have the balti, which is again a very traditional dish made and served in a balti. As you can see, it's the literal translation of balti is a bucket. We have the murk peshavri, which is one of our most popular dishes and dishes that has won awards for us. We have the spinach, which is basically just ground spinach with cumin seeds, garlic and ginger. We have the jinga malai curry, which is a very Goan prawn curry, thin coconut curry cooked with prawns. We have the traditional biryani, the lamb biryani, which is also a very, very popular dish. And the lachha paratha is the wholemeal bread with layered. It's a layered bread, not a leavened bread. And it's made out of wholemeal, which is healthy at the same time. Here we have the basic ingredients that we use to finish our dishes. Garlic that is used basically for initial cooking of the dishes, the red onions that we use, finishing we have the mint leaves, we have the coriander. Accompaniments that go with the meal are chili pickle, tamarind chutney, mango chutney, and of course to finish a good Indian meal you need the mango lassi, which is the traditional buttermilk but flavored with mango.
If you're looking for some delicious Indian cuisine and an all-round fantastic night out, then you can't go past Ravi's Cumin next time you're in Sydney.